church and state are united again. Again, God's people, like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who went through the fiery furnace, go through a time of trouble. But once again, Jesus steps forth. Once again, Jesus protects his people. Once again, Jesus comes to deliver his people. Once again, at the time of the end, God's people, like in the days of ancient Babylon, will be oppressed and persecuted. Now, the book of Revelation predicts that at a time of social chaos, political crisis, natural disasters, and economic collapse, Jesus returns to the He'll reign eternally. He'll establish his throne securely in the universe forever. He'll establish for his throne. God will be the attack. And Europe will be the court of God. And Christ will come and will walk through the street, through the gates of the city, into the limitless space to worship in New Jerusalem. Now, Revelation 17, verse 6. Talks about that time of difficulty when religious liberty fades like the sun fading in the western sky, bringing in darkness. Take your Bible, please, and turn to Revelation 17, verse 6. This is an expansion on Revelation chapter 13. In Revelation chapter 17, verse 6, it says, I saw the woman drunk with the blood of the saints and with the blood of martyrs of Jesus. And when I saw her, I marveled with great amazement. A universal death decree has been passed, according to Revelation 13, which we'll look at momentarily. And so much blood of the martyrs has been shed that according to this verse, rebels like a drunkard. Now let me be very clear. God is the mark on their right hand and their forehead. No man might buy or sell, except one who has the mark of the name of the beast or the number of his name. So somebody says, Pastor Mark, I shake and tremble when I think of that time that nobody could buy or sell. I shake and tremble when I think of that time of religious liberty going, because I don't know if I can make it. The good news is you can't. The better news is with Jesus you can't. Jesus does not give us the faith of martyrs until the time of martyrdom. As we develop faith in Jesus every day today, as we trust him in the trials of life, as we go through the challenges of life, not in our own strength, but as in Jesus' strength, we are developing faith that will be intensified, magnified, enlarged in the time of difficulty, so that in his strength and by his power, we can go through. Now comment on Revelation, the 13th chapter. In this little book called Last Day Events, in the Ellen White is quoting the Great Controversy, page 578-579. Read it. So it is a comment on Revelation 13. The prophecy of Revelation 13 declares that the power represented by the beast with lamb-like horns shall cause the earth and them that dwell therein to worship the papacy. They are symbolized by the beast like unto a leopard. This prophecy will be fulfilled when the United States shall enforce Sunday observance, which Rome claims as the special acknowledgement of her supremacy. Now, listen to this quote or read it from the screen. And you read it with me from the screen. Political corruption is destroying love of justice and regard for truth. And even in free America, rulers and legislators, in order to secure public favor, will yield to the popular demand for a law enforcing some terms. Now let's analyze that statement a little bit, because it is a very critical statement, extremely important to understand. First, political corruption is destroying justice. Do we see any political corruption today?
any political corruption today.
Our good is destroying love of justice and regard for truth. You see that happen? Even in free America.